Teenage driver who hit and killed a man walking along this rural road. And even worse, that teen and his father knew the victim. In fact, they were neighbors. Action News reporter Sheldon Ingram is in Fawn Township to explain how it happened.
The residents who live here along Howes Run Road say it's not out of the ordinary for residents to walk along this road. But today, that exercise turned fatal.
Just after 10 o'clock this morning, a man taking his daily walk along this road was struck by a Chevy Blazer driven by a teenager. One resident heard the disturbing sound of tires tearing into the road just before 62-year-old John Walters was hit and killed.
I heard tires screeching. I heard a lot of commotion.
It was apparent he was walking down the road, and according to the other driver, he walked further into the middle of the road and was struck.
Walter's family would not go on camera, but they tell Channel 4 Action News he'd walk this road twice a day. Not only did Walters use this road for daily exercise, but other relatives and residents on this road did it as well. Despite the very narrow and shallow shoulder, residents still take chances. This time, the walk has a tragic outcome.
Surprised, but not surprised. Surprised in that someone was hit. But not surprised, because I walk this road a lot myself, especially in the wintertime, and I've had several close calls.
He did it for weights, you know, and stuff, and he lost a lot of weight, and he was doing really good.
Police would not identify the driver, but residents say he lives only 300 yards from where he struck Walters. Residents know both the victim and the driver.
The boy that hit him is just a super kid, like I said, a great neighborhood kid.
Oh, it makes even doublier sad, because the young boy is, he's a good, really, really good kid. And I know he's just sick about it.
Although the teenager is described as a very good kid, investigators still had to conduct the blood alcohol test, but results won't be available for several days. In Fawn Township, Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.